Let's say a little prayer before we start our day. Let us thank God for the lovely things He has given us. For all that He has given us.
The participants, I am you all on behalf of Brihan Mumbai Municipal Corporation Education Department. Myself, Vidya Madhukar Bangar. Today's our topic name is equations. And in this topic, we will going to learn how to solve an equation. Okay, students. When I ask you some question, then the please raise your hand. Okay, in last lecture we learned what is equations. First we will revise this. Okay, you might have seen fruits and vegetable vendors in the market using the vendor scale. Okay, this is vendor scale, weight scale. If you go to the vendor and ask 2 kg of apples, he put 2 kg weight on the side and apples on the other side. If apples are heavier, he starts removing some apples and he continues to do so till both the sides scale are balanced. Okay. So if both the sides of weight are balanced, we can say weight of apples is equal to 2 kg. So both the sides are balanced and we can see weight of apples is equal to 2 kg. We can represent this mathematically, that we can replace this is equal to. Okay. This is equal to. Okay. Is equal to by equal to sign. See. Equal to sign. We replace this equal to word to equal to. So weight of apples is equal to 2 kg. Okay, and this is an equation. Okay, this is an equation. Okay. So in mathematics, the sign of equality. This is sign of equality. The sign of equality shows that the numbers from both sides they may be the result of different operations on the left hand side and right hand side. Such an expression of equality is called an equation. Example, 45 minus 30. Here, 5 plus 10. Okay. 10 gives 15 and 45 minus 30 gives 15. Okay, so both sides here, both sides are equal and this is called an equation. Okay, students. So, this is we already learned in the previous lecture. Today, we will going to learn what is variable, then how to solve equation. Okay, see. Look at the school, then shop, still open. In this picture, the distance between the house and the school is seen to be 300 meters. Okay, in this picture, the distance between the house and the school is seen to be 300 meters. Okay, the same straight road. Okay, see here, on the same straight road, there is a shop. Okay, this is shop. And this is school. House and this is shop. On the same straight road, there is a shop between the school and house. Okay, and the distance between the shop and the house is 190 meters. Okay, first see in this picture the distance between the house and the school is to be 300 meters. On the same straight road, there is a shop between the school and the house. The distance between the shop and the house is 109 meters. Then, what is the distance between the school and the shop? This is school and this is shop. Then, what is the distance between the school and the shop? Okay. We don't know. So, for that, for find out the distance between the school and shop, instead of writing the number, we suppose that the distance is x. We suppose that distance is x. Okay. And that is the distance we have to find out. Okay. We do so. We write it as x. Okay. See, that is the distance we find out. Now, look at the picture. Okay, look at the picture. The sum of x and 190. See, sum of x and 190 should be 100. Sum of x and 190 should be 300. Okay, let's we write this in the form of an equation. Okay, see, x plus 190 equal to 300. X plus 190 equal to 300. Here, x means that is the distance we have to find out. Okay. X is the distance we find out. First, we suppose, okay, we don't know value of x. So, first, we suppose x equal to 7. Okay. Here, suppose x equal to 70. Then, okay, students, tell me 70 plus 1 equal to what? Now, tell me what is the answer of 70 plus 190. Please raise your hand. 7 plus 190. Okay, very good. 260. Okay. 70 plus 90 equal to 260. 260. Okay. But see, here is 300. Okay. X plus 190 is 300 and we got 260. Here we got 260. That is less than the right hand side. Okay, because here 300 and we got 260. Means that is less than the right hand side, because here our right hand side is 300. Okay, then we suppose x equal to 150. Okay, suppose x equal to 150. Then now tell me what is the answer of 150 plus 190? 150 plus 190. What is the answer of 150 plus 190?
Means 240. No.
240 or 340?
Sorry, 340. 340.
Okay, very good, very good. Okay. So 150 plus 190 equal to 340. Okay. Then the our left hand side. Okay. Then the left hand side becomes 150 plus 190 equal to 340. This is written as right hand side. Okay. Our right hand is, side is 300. Now we take x equal to 110. Equal to 110. Tell me what is the answer of 110 plus 190?
Means 300.
Very, very good. 100 plus 190 equal to 300. Okay. 100 plus 190 equal to 300. Now our left hand side and right hand side are equal and equation has balance. See here, our right hand side and left hand side are equal and our equation has balance. Okay, so x equal to 100, x equal to 100, it means that the value of x or the distance between the shop and the pool was 100 meters. Okay, in an equation, a meter is sometimes. Okay, it means that the value of x or the distance between the shop and school was 100 meter. Okay. Students, in an equation, a letter is sometimes used in the place of number. Okay, use x for a number. Such a letter is called a variable. Okay, the value x in the school was 100 meters. And in a letter is sometimes used in a place of number. Here x is used for number, so x is called a variable. Okay, so here x is variable, and the value of the variable which balances or satisfies the equation is called the solution to the equation. Okay, here value of x is 110. Okay, value of x is 110. So the solution to the equation x plus 190 equal to 300 is 110. So our solution is 110. Okay, x is called variable. X is called variable, and value x is called solution. So our here solution is 110. Okay, students, in this example, we take lots of time for find out the value of x. Okay, we got, we take lots of time for, first we take x equal to x equal to 70, then we take x equal to 150. Okay, means we take lots of time for find out the value of x. So now we will going to learn how find out value of variable, or we can say how solve an equation. Okay, students, look at the picture. In this picture, one side of weight scale containing watermelon and two apples, and other side of weight scale containing five apples. Okay, both the sides are balanced. So in this case, for find out the weight of a watermelon in term of apple, okay, we remove, see here, for find out weight of watermelons in terms of apple, we remove two apples from each of the pans. Okay, so here remaining a watermelon, and here remaining three apples. Okay, we remove two apples from each pan. So here remaining one watermelon, and here remaining three apples. Okay, see. Then we can see that one watermelon weighs three apples. Okay, we will using same method for solving an equation with an variable. Okay, we will using same method, we carry out the same operation on both side of the equation to obtain simpler balanced equation. Because if the first equation is balanced, okay, because first equation is balanced, then the new one obtained in this way is also balanced. Okay, the equation becomes simpler and simpler, and finally we get the value of the variable, that is the solution to the equation. See here, we use x for weight of a watermelon. Okay, we use x for weight of watermelon. Okay, so x plus 2 means two apples. Okay, equal to 5 apples. Here 5 apples, x used for watermelon 2, here 2 apples, and 5 apples. Okay, this is our equation. Okay, one side of weight scale containing one watermelon and 2 apples, so x plus 2, and other side of weight scale containing 5 apples. Okay, and both the sides are balanced. So our equation is x plus 2 equal to 5. Okay, students, now look at this equation. We have constant 2 and 5 and variable x. Okay, equation means what? Two things are same value, left hand side should be equal to right hand side. So whatever you adding, left hand side should be adding in right hand side. Whatever you subtracting from left hand side should be subtracting from right hand side. Okay, always both sides should be equal. Okay, I want value of x, here I want value of x. Okay, okay, how we can remove plus 2? We remove plus 2 by writing -2. Okay. So whatever you subtracting for left hand side should be subtracting from right hand side. So here also 5 - 2. Okay. Then our next step is +2 - 2 gives 0. So x plus 0 equal to 3. So x equal to 3. Okay. Here x is variable and 3 is value of variable and 3 is called solution to equation. Okay. Okay, students. Let us take a second look at the previous equation. Okay, our previous equation is x plus 190. Okay. See, x plus 190 equal to 300. Okay, then in this equation, we have constant 190 and 300 and variable x. I want value of x. I want value of x. Okay. Here in left hand side, extra plus 190. Okay. Extra plus 190. So by writing minus 190, we can remove plus 190. Okay. Whenever you subtracting from left hand side, should be subtracting from right hand side. So here 300 minus 190. Okay. Then plus 190 minus 190 gives 0. So x plus 0 equal to 300 minus 190, 110. Okay. So x equal to 110. Okay. Students, while solving an equation, we can use it in simple way rather than examine several random methods. Okay. See. Okay. Solve the following equation. Our equation is y minus 5 equal to 2. Okay. Now I want value of y. So how we can remove minus 5? Give me answer. How we can remove minus 5? Please give me answer. How we can remove minus 5? Hello, students. Hello, how we can remove minus 5? Hello,
Miss, 5 minus 2 is equal to 3.
Okay, very good. Okay. By adding plus 5, we can remove minus 5. Okay, here y minus 5 plus 5 equal to, what are you adding on LHS? Means left hand side should be adding on right hand side. So y minus 5 plus 5 equal to 2 plus 5. Okay, here minus 5 plus 5 gives 0. Okay. So, y plus 0 equal to 2 plus 5 equal to 7. So, y equal to 7. Okay. Y equal to 7. And this is our answer. Y equal to 7. Now, we take word problem. Okay, see. Jasmine had some money. Mother gave her 7 rupees. Okay. Jasmine now has 10 rupees. How much did she have to start with? Okay, this is our example. Okay, word problem. So, let's suppose Jasmine had y rupees. Okay. Here y is variable. Okay. For solving this problem, we take y variable. Okay, here y is variable. Jasmine has some money. Mother gave her 7 rupees. Mother gave her 7 rupees. So, see, y plus 7 equal to 10. Y is Jasmine had y rupees and mother gave her 7 rupees. So, y plus 7 equal to 10. Okay. Because Jasmine has 7 rupees. So, y plus 7 equal to 10. Then, here. Okay. We want value of y. So, here. We remove plus 7 by subtracting minus 7. See here. Y plus 7 minus 7 equal to 10 minus 7. Okay. Then our next step is plus 7 minus 7 gives 0. So, y plus 0 equal to 10 minus 7. 3. Okay, 10 minus 7, 3. So, y plus 0 equal to 3. So, y equal to 3. It means that Jasmine had 3 rupees to start with. Jasmine had 3 rupees to start it. Okay. So, student. Okay. What we have learned from this session, we have learned first equation. So, what is equation? Equation means whenever things are balanced or equal, we can represent them using an equal to sign. That is an equation. Whenever things are balanced or equal, we can represent them using an equal to sign. That is an equation. Then we also learn what is variable. Okay. In an equation, a letter is sometimes used in place of a number. Such a letter is called a variable. Okay. In an equation, a letter is sometimes used in place of a number. Such a letter is called a variable. Then, okay, we also learn how to solve an equation. Okay, so, okay, student, this is our today's session. I hope you understood. Here we completed our 10th chapter, equations. Thank you for attending today's session. Thank you.